You might have asked yourself, who should I listen to? A dumb person with a lot of wisdom or a smart person with a lot of education? In this video, I will tell you why the latter can give you some of the worst life advice imaginable. I will use the YouTuber Thunderf00t as a case study. He's one of the early big science YouTubers, who has done some great videos in the past rebutting creationists, feminists, and scams on Kickstarter. He does so by using basic physics and chemistry to explain why certain things cannot work. Phil Mason, the man behind the channel, is a doctor of chemistry who has published papers in Nature and Science, and is obviously a very smart person. So why not take his word as gospel, you might ask? To understand why, I will have to introduce you to the Dunning-Kruger effect. Let's say you know nothing about the specific subject, then your confidence to give your opinion about it will be very low. Then you read a book or watch a YouTube video and you will believe that you know more, and thus your confidence in this subject will increase. It is thus very easy to draw the conclusion that the more books you read, the higher your confidence level will be. However, this is not the case. In reality, your initial confidence boost is false, since you know so little about that subject that you are not even aware of how much you do not know. And typically, when you try to apply your knowledge to real-world problems, that is when your confidence severely tanks. Smart, educated people are especially vulnerable to the Dunning-Kruger effect, since they performed well in school and take this as proof that they know a subject, but never leave themselves open to apply their knowledge to real problems and get slapped in the face by the complexity of reality. So how does this tie into Thunderf00t? I would say that he legit knows his physics and chemistry, both in theory and practice, and he deserves to speak about this with confidence, and here it is wise to listen to him. But what smart people like him always tend to do is that since they know one subject really well, they think that they can also extrapolate this knowledge into completely different fields too, and this is a big no-no. So since he is here in physics and chemistry, he believes that he's here in engineering, manufacturing, economics, and business as well, while in reality, he is here. And this is a huge blind spot that smart, educated people often have. This becomes obvious when you listen to his criticism of Elon Musk's business ventures. Thunderf00t's political beliefs and huge ego makes him jealous of Elon's accomplishments. So he tries to justify these feelings with faulty understandings of engineering, manufacturing, and economics. Like, for instance, in his video SpaceX Busted, Thunderf00t believes he knows business, but he doesn't even understand the difference between cost and price.
Basically, I'm not seeing any great reduction in the price per rocket when, if they were getting real savings out of reusing the rockets, these prices should be crashing like crazy.
Cost is how much money it takes to make a thing. Price is how much you charge a customer. The difference between cost and price gives your profit. Thus, SpaceX can decrease their launch costs while keeping the price the same. And if there is no valid competition, they could even increase their price. Watch Dr. Know-It-All or AstroKiwi's rebuttal video if you want to know the details. Thunderf00t often criticizes prototypes for being expensive as a reason for why Musk's ventures are doomed to fail.
And having hundreds of tunnels all over the city. Yeah, there's a problem with that. It's ridiculously expensive to build tunnels. Recover your rocket engines, which I'm not so sure about the economics of this. For those who are like, rah, 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 Musk can do anything. Nah. While they've recovered some of the launch vehicles, as of three quarters of the way through 2016, they've never reused any of them.
But in May 2021, a rocket booster had been recovered and reused 10 times. So it's almost like companies can do technological development and get more efficient over time. But Thunderf00t's science education hasn't taught him about Wright's law, which states that the more units you make, the cheaper they are to manufacture. Also, virtually all businesses operate at a loss until they scale their manufacturing. But again, he speaks with full confidence about this in the same way he does for physics and chemistry. Thunderf00t has also convinced himself that starting a successful car company is easy, since building a prototype electric car is easy.
Starting a car company isn't exactly rocket science. Electric cars aren't exactly new. As for his brilliant ideas, like rockets that take off and land vertically, nope, that was all done last century. He's just done the exact same thing with better cameras and a lot better PR.
His peak Dunning-Kruger position prevents him from understanding that it is the manufacturing that is the hard part, not making the prototype.
Like, there's literally 1,000%, maybe 10,000% more work that goes into the production system than the thing itself. So say, like, how much effort have we put into, say, designing Raptor versus designing the manufacturing system? It's 10 to 100 times more effort to design the manufacturing system than the engine.
Of Raptor?
Oh yeah, absolutely, especially with Raptor. The amount of effort that goes into the design rounds down to zero.
right.
Relative to the amount of effort that goes into the manufacturing system. Yeah. This is, like, just very fundamentally underappreciated. If people have not been in manufacturing, especially manufacturing of something that's relatively new, then they don't understand, and they think the design is the hard part, and they think production is like a copier or something like that.
Right.
This is completely false.
The reason for this is if you mass manufacture a complex machine, like a car, the machine that makes this machine are orders of magnitude more complicated than the car. Because of this, Tesla and Ford are the only car companies in the United States that has not yet gone bankrupt. But Thunderf00t seems to think that this is easy. A separate problem when taking advice from smart, educated people is that they tend to have a strong ego, and Thunderf00t is no exception from this. An ego is healthy when it motivates you to defend your views and help you fend away people that are out to fuck with your head. But when the ego gets too big, it will start to defend your views against reality, and it does so by lying and being intellectually dishonest. Other intelligent people will then start to distance themselves from this big ego person, because they cannot know when the person actually knows what they are talking about, or when they are just defending their ego while acting totally confident. This is highlighted in the video, Why Tesla Batteries Suck. Thunderf00t's main point is that it's because the range is too short and the charge time is too long. He says that the charge time is 1 hour for a Tesla, thus making it unsuitable for going on road trips.
Tesla battery? Well, the Model 3, according to the Tesla website, has a charge time of 20 to 30 hours. And if you take it to a supercharging station, someone's kindly done a time lapse of that, and it takes just under 2 hours. Although that's apparently with the long-range Tesla battery that has a range of about 300 miles. Nonetheless, with supercharging, you're probably looking at over an hour for about 200 miles of range. So if I'm driving at 70 miles per hour or so, I'll deplete the Tesla battery in about 3 hours, at which point I'll have to stop and recharge, which optimistically at a supercharging station is going to take about an hour. Whereas my old gas-powered car from the last millennium can drive for about 6 hours and only has to stop to refuel for about 5 minutes. And that's the reason why Tesla batteries suck.
Well, except for that he's totally wrong here. In the example where Thunderf00t obtained his charge time from, charging from 0 miles to 200 miles actually took 30 minutes, not over an hour as Thunderf00t used in his calculations. And what Thunderf00t doesn't tell you is that no sane person would charge their car from 0 to 100% on a road trip, but instead charge from maybe 5% to 70% of the full range. This is because the charging time gets slower as the battery gets fuller. Thunderf00t obviously knows this, but because his case against electric cars are starting to crumble as battery pack energy densities increases and charge times decreases, he has to start stretching the truth to save face. Then, in February of 2019, he made this bold prediction.
And for those hoping that there's going to be some great battery revolution here, it's not going to happen. Battery technology is probably as energy dense as it's going to get. if you want to maintain things like safety, reliability, and rechargeability.
Well, that didn't age well. Just 5 months later, Tesla opened their version 3 of the superchargers, where it's possible to charge to 200 miles in 20 minutes instead of 30 minutes in the Thunderfoot's own example. And in June of 2021, Tesla released the Model S Plaid with a range in the order of 390 miles, which makes it possible for you to drive for more than 5 hours before recharging. Another separate problem when taking advice from academic people is that during their whole career, they have been dependent on taxpayer money to fund their salary and their research. And Thunderfoot probably gets his money from the government too, which is why he doesn't like private enterprises competing with the academic way of doing things. Academic people can feel threatened by ventures that doesn't need the government to thrive, because it just highlights what a waste of money university research really is. So to justify their existence, they tend to have a more pro-government stance.
There's been a referendum, the Brexit referendum. You're looking at losing millions of pounds of British research money.
So why should you care about this? Thunderfoot is entertaining, so what harm does it make? Well, I will tell you why. Money. If you were to listen to Thunderfoot when he did his first video criticizing Musk, you would be reluctant to invest in any of his business ventures, because you would be thinking, maybe Thunderfoot is right, and Elon Musk is a con man, and I will lose all my money. When he posted his first video criticizing Musk in 2016, you could have bought Tesla stock for $40. Today, they are worth $1,177, which is a 29 times increase. But if you were a Thunderfoot fundamentalist, he would have robbed you from this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. This actually happened to a friend of mine who introduced me to Thunderfoot's channel back in the day. When I pointed out that Tesla stock will be going up, he gave a bunch of Thunderfoot lines of why this wouldn't happen, so he missed out an opportunity to 29x his money. In summary, smart people are especially susceptible to the Dunning-Kruger effect, and often think that they can extrapolate their deep knowledge in one field to a completely different one. Smart people are typically susceptible to have a very large ego, which can force them to be intellectually dishonest. Blindly listening to a person who is often right can set you up for trouble the time this person is wrong, so always do your own research. Thank you guys for watching this video, and don't forget to like and subscribe, and leave a comment if you think I'm correct, or leave a comment if you think I'm incorrect. I would like, as a closing thought, I would like to say a couple of places where I do align with Thunderfoot's view on Elon Musk, and one of them is the Hyperloop, which I think is overly complicated and the technology just isn't there yet. And also I believe that Elon Musk has a tendency to overpromise his timelines with about 1 to 10 years. And Elon Musk also has a tendency to over-engineer concepts such as the self-presenting door handles and the Falcon Wing doors on the Model X, which could have been made much simpler and would have saved them a bunch of headache and time. But Musk has a tendency to deliver on things that are seen to be impossible before he actually does it, and that is why he deserves respect. See you in the next video!